What goes around just comes around. 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 What goes around is time again. 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 What goes around is time again.
What's up, bitches? It's Friday, and it is the day before the 4th of July, which is why the show is on not only 15 minutes late, but also at noon Eastern Daylight Time.
So we can get our party on.
That's right. That's right. I mean, you know, I know that we have some European viewers that tune in, but the 4th of July really is a fantastic excuse to just get totally, you know, shit-faced, to blow shit up, and to generally just, like, not really have any responsibilities for a
couple days.
You know
what I love about the 4th of July?
What's that? Nice guy.
It's just every year it's a reminder to the Brits that we fucking kick their ass our independence, motherfuckers.
And all like 19 people from the UK that listen to the show now no longer listen to the show.
Dude,
I hope that
mercantilism
realize
for
that.
The loss.
Yeah. I'm DJ Wheat. Joining me as always, Force and Nice Guy Ed. And this is our Independence Day EG. In fact, today is going to be a little bit shorter. And we're going to be mixing up the format just a little bit. Obviously, we're going to be talking about Ghostbusters today, but I think we're just going to talk about Ghostbusters right off the bat. Force just got back from Texas. He's not going to be here next week, so DEERA is going to join us again next week. And sorry, Force, you know.
Sorry.
Yeah.
sorry, guys. Sorry to the audience. That's
where
what
are you
should apologize
be?
To.
Where are you going
to
be? Doing training? Or
yeah, Denver. I have to like learn how to work with others. We have to go to a week-long training, spend thousands of dollars to teach
Good.
People how to work with each
Thank
other.
Thank God.
I got to clarify something for
what?
You, Danny.
What?
Yeah, you didn't really find us. Like, we escaped from European oppression for religious freedom. And
here it comes.
You know, life, just, liberty.
It's so early in the morning, I'm going to fall asleep
know,
during our
I
show.
I know. How about, Ed, how about you make a video game about it?
Dude, I think there probably is one.
You could call it America, Fuck Yeah.
No, you can just go listen to that, like, God Bless the USA song on repeat. Like a private
what? Battle for America game. There should be.
I don't. It sounds like you are the man
Dude,
to take charge.
Isn't that like Stratego?
How about a whole MMO where over the evolution of the MMO, you're just
you're
constantly
establishing.
But there's
American
never
dominance.
A way for the Britons to for the British to win. Maybe something like that. Anyway, I love the Brits, so don't get the wrong idea. Here. Ed's a hater, but
no,
he,
dude, I love
no,
their,
actually,
I love their whiskey.
You're just all about the history, right?
I love their whiskey and some of their beers.
So we're going to do things a little bit different. Obviously, we've got an hour show today. We are normally on Fridays at 7 p.m. EDT and 2 hour shows, but just today, 1 hour show. So we're going to kick things off with something a little bit different. We're going to start off with our review, and that way we can then get into the news of the week. There's definitely been some weird shit going on this week in the games industry, like people saying weird stuff, it coming from like weird sources, all sorts of like all
just
sorts
all
of
like
stuff.
Predictions based on nothing,
right?
But
and so I'm worried that if we get into that, then we're gonna screw ourselves. And by the way, Ed, you might want to plug that laptop in, because if you don't, you're gonna be freaking out in like 10 minutes when it shuts down. See right there, that how the
why is
AC
it why is it unplugged
cable,
I wonder.
I don't know. When you turned it
blame,
around.
Blame, yes.
I'm blaming it on Force this
blame
time.
Blame Force.
So this week, I got a chance. Actually, Force last week purchased Ghostbusters. And I was very happy that you brought it over so I could actually review the game. And so we're going to be talking a little bit about Ghostbusters for the PS3 and the 360. I only played it on the 360. I did see that there was a couple PS3 360 comparisons out there. But as far as I know, they're pretty much the same.
They're pretty much
game.
Identical. With the 360 being just slightly superior in most areas.
Right. Whatever. So that's to be debated. But anyway, prior to me actually getting my hands on this title, I have to admit, Force, there was an awful lot of hate. There was an awful lot of like, oh my god, this game blows ass, it sucks, I read some poor reviews, people saying that they got it early and they didn't like it. And so I was definitely not going into this title
I wouldn't say
like,
I was like apprehensive because like I wanted it to be really good, and I wasn't sure if it, you know, felt like they announced it and then it came out like it seemed like it was you know, develop very quickly. So I was a little bit worried that, you know, it might just be a quick cash in. And I was happy to say it wasn't.
Yeah.
There's the answer right there.
Yeah, they say
you.
The PS3 runs at 540p and the 360 runs at 720p. It's very interesting.
No, I mean, did I call it? I don't need any facts. I just know in my gut. That
yeah, that's kind of like what happened.
I just know in my gut.
That's
kind of
like what happened with BioShock on the PS3. Oh, yeah. Yeah, that's right. Wasn't that BioShock on the PS3?
I don't know, that was
the PC version, my bad.
Oh, yeah, where they were like showing frames and showing you how we were getting less of a viewing angle.
I guess that was it. so anyway, Ghostbusters, you started up. The first thing that I got to say about this game is, holy shit, the stupidity that both Force, it sounds like, and I experienced. So when you start up the game, you get the typical rigmarole bullshit, you know, select a storage device. You know, are you sure you want to save it here? It's like, yeah, I'm fucking sure. And then you go and you start playing your game. However, where the problem lies is that when you start Ghostbusters for the second time, go to select your storage device, it then says, warning, the save game data will be overwritten if you select a storage device or something.
Exactly.
That
it makes you sound like you're going to erase your game.
Right.
Start a new game. You will erase everything you've done.
And so I'm sitting there going, well, wait a second. No, that can't be right. Did I select the wrong thing? And I go back and I go back. And finally, like, I think you had called me back. But I was about to call Force and be like, I think I'm about to cry. If I have to do two more levels of this shit, you know, over again, I don't know if I can handle that. And he's like, just do it.
No. What I said, yeah, just do it, dude. I was already on GameFAQs exploring it. Like, I freaking had the same thing where I went to the internet and was a little sketched out.
Before we continue, we need to clarify. No, this is not live right now. What you're watching is not happening.
It's not.
This is pre-recorded.
There is no spoon.
And actually, you know what? If we play this later, then what I'm saying is true. So there you go. Two birds with one stone. Birds with one stone.
Dude, you're blowing my mind.
I know,
over
like
here, dog.
On drums. Did
you're
he say it correctly?
My fucking
didn't
mind.
He? I don't want to put too much thought into it.
You're blowing my mind. It's a pre-recorded live show, basically, is what you're saying. I mean, like, holy shit, right off the bat. And you actually were like, wait, just select.
Just do it. Just do it.
But
getting past that.
Yeah, we got
What'd you think of it? I mean, not that you talk about this much, but just like the tiny little intro screen. It did not like perfectly look like they're building. You see cars zooming by.
Yeah.
Like,
oh, yeah.
I was like, wow.
And then the Ghostbusters music kicks in, and we've got some footage here.
From what I saw, dude, it looks so dope. I'm gonna play it now that Wheat's done with it, because neither Wheat or I wanted to like rent it or buy it, because we're like,
you know,
dude, what if it sucks?
And that's just it. Is I'm gonna come right out, straight up, and I'm gonna say this game to me is nothing more than a rental. I went through it fairly quickly. I probably 3-4 play sessions, but honestly, I can't, you know, I didn't play the multiplayer.
See, that's why
so
I knew you were going to step in here and say that.
I begged him,
please just play one round of the multiplayer.
But still, considering, like, I just got BlazBlue, I'm playing a lot of Street Fighter 4, those are my go-to multiplayer games. How much multiplayer would I play? We'll let you answer that when we get to the multiplayer. Let's talk about the single player. Fucking great. What blew me away about this movie and basically negates anything negative
about
that I could
game.
Probably say is the fact that you've got the modeling of all the original characters, you've got them writing the story, you've got them voicing the voices, you've got the same kind of fucked up humor that they had in the first game. They reference the old movies.
They do reference all the old movies, and the jokes totally fit in with their characters as they pop up throughout.
Yes, anyone who is a fan of these movies is going to love every second of this game. Now, there were some times where I felt like it dragged, but I mean, thanks to like the really, really, really nice like universe that they're in and the mechanics that you play with and you could choose how you want to play, I thought it did just a fucking great job, dude, of recreating the Ghostbusters.
And I thought
universe.
They did a really good job, too, of adding new things to it, because, you know, that first time you capture that ghost, it is such an unbelievable experience seeing what your proton beam looks like, fighting against it, trying to drag it into your trap that you threw out yourself. But you kind of wondered, can I do this the whole game? And they did a neat job of introducing new weapons to the Ghostbusters universe without making them feel like they totally didn't fit
in. And it
in.
Was funny because every time you get a new weapon, it's graphically represented on your pack. And it's really awesome how it, like, your pack evolves over time. And, you know, the gameplay
is
simple.
The way they can, like, display your HUD on your pack, too.
Right,
I mean, like,
right.
That was
yeah,
just awesome
your,
the way
your
they do
health
that.
Is on your pack. Like, your exhaust bar is on your pack. And you know, with that being said, the gameplay is pretty simple. In fact, I would almost say it's like, imagine Ghostbusters meets Gears of War without the cover system. You know, the running feels the same. You get knocked down as a ragdoll, which I hated, by the way, because it always jacked up your aim. But, I mean, like, other than that, I didn't have any problems with the movement, with the aiming, with the weapons that you got. You earn money through damage and capturing ghosts to upgrade all your weapons. But, I mean, like, inherently, the gameplay was solid. Like,
It felt like not only Ghostbusters, but it felt familiar to the first-person shooter Gears of War crowd right away. I mean, like, the way it controlled so smoothly. And, you know, when you first drag a beam on a monster, it just felt right.
It felt good. It feels right. And then the upgrades will give you, like, some more power. Maybe your beam causes less recoil and whatnot. The other thing that's nice about this game is that it's very forgiving on you hitting the other Ghostbusters, because the AI isn't perfect. In fact, I found the AI to be stupid even sometimes in advancing, like, scenes. Like, guys would be sitting around and I'd be like, oh, I needed to take one step further, or I need to, like, budge Ray out of the way or so. But I mean, it was so minor, I just kept
going.
But it
never, like, stopped the game.
It never stopped the game. So I just gotta say, if you are a fan of Ghostbusters, the movie, the lore, any of those comedians, like, this game is top notch. And a lot of I did see, like, IGN and some of the other sites, Metacritic, it's a lot of eights out there. And, you know, I mean, as a single player game, I would say an eight is probably a pretty fair score. Some of the guys that went, like, low and six and sevens, I just don't feel like that is fair at all. Graphically, the game is great. There's constantly shit going on. The physics, for the most part, is really solid. So, I mean, I really, really had fun with Ghostbusters.
You know, the only thing that threw me off a little bit was I told you that it was really difficult. There were some parts there in the game, I don't know if you remember, where you had to, like, stone bats flew around and you had to tether one into a stone bat and then to a fence so they'd smash into it.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah.
Well, in the mode that I was playing, two hits, you were dead. So that scene, I replayed it so many times, and you have a nasty load screen every time you die.
And are your teammates reviving you?
No, your teammates are constantly dropping too. So, like, I'd run to res a teammate and get killed.
Try
to avoid them, get killed. You know, so there were some parts that really kicked my ass. There were a couple of bosses where I spent the entire time reviving my teammates, only getting a couple shots in and reviving my teammates, because you want to keep them up because they'll bring you back when you die.
Right.
So,
right. So that was happening in that.
There were some parts where I constantly had to babysit.
So I haven't played it yet.
Right.
How do they integrate using the, like,
trap?
The trap.
You just throw
you
it
throw,
out,
You
dude.
Throw it out and it throws up a beam, and then you have to wrangle a ghost and you can slam them into the ground so you can drag them a little more and drag them towards the beam area that's
And then you
out.
Also get upgrades where you can, like, slam them and do, like, an insta-trap if you slam them right on the trap. There's a lot of cool, like, little things.
And there's,
like,
a lot of neat, like, achievements that go, I bet they're popping up all the time for you, like, a lot of neat ones that you get as you do all these neat acrobatics to be able to slime tether a ghost and then hit the other side of your trap and it sucks it in. And the end boss was pretty sweet. I mean, like, all the way to the end.
It might have been pretty easy, but
it was still pretty epic looking. Isn't it
an extension of the stories, or is it, like...
Basically, what they are is they're bringing in a fifth guy. They've gotten popular, you know, that's still back in that story. And the city wants a ghost-free city, so they've pretty much given the Ghostbusters, they said, we'll pay for everything. You keep ghosts out of our city, and they kind of got...
So
carte blanche
to
screw up what they want
puffed.
In the city. Because what happens is the museum is showing the Gozer exhibit. And they bring it out and it releases spirit.
Okay,
so it gives them an excuse to revisit the first couple of movies and then take it a little
bit
further.
I want to comment on something about that, Force, because I will admit there's one thing. I wish that there would have been a little bit more originality outside of those movies. Like, I really felt like they paid an awesome homage to both the movies, But they could have gone just a little bit for... I mean, dude, don't get me wrong. I love fighting the Stay Puft Marshmallow Man. Like, that was awesome. And there's also some references to Gozar the Gozerian in, like, later on. I don't know if you know what I'm talking about, but there's one in particular that's really awesome.
Oh, there's all kinds.
Yeah, yeah. So I like that, but I felt like, you know, I felt like I would have liked to see him gone one step further with the... You know, their creativity in terms of the ghosts that they made, you know, right. And you do
it's
see
like
the gray lady.
They wanted
from the
to
first
recreate.
One.
They wanted to recreate yeah. some of those scenes. So, yeah,
no,
you know, they wanted to give you an
absolutely.
Excuse to fight
yeah,
Slimer.
And
then
I could see that because, like, when
librarian.
You're playing the game, like, if they didn't add that, wouldn't you be like, dude, how sweet would it have been if you could have fought the Stay Puft Marshmallow?
Yeah.
You know,
and it
so
was
kind
of neat because when you watch
I
a movie, like, the librarian scares the crap out of them in the first movie. And they're like, ooh, you know, we never did get that one. You know, like, this is our chance to go back and
right.
get it. So there were some cool
right.
moments.
Right. And that, I did like that. They worked that in really well. And I could totally see them busting out another one of these, you know, especially there's been a lot of talk about Ghostbusters
and
3,
maybe,
you know, and
if
so
you're lucky,
what?
There'll be a zombie pack for Ghostbusters, dude.
No, and I don't. Well, maybe that's where we need to shift things over.
I was gonna say, let's talk about
the
multiplayer.
Again, I didn't play it. So from a single player perspective, if the game was only single player, I would just rent it. Force seems to say that the multiplayer is the bomb.
And I actually
I don't
thought
know.
The single player was awesome, too, because you didn't mention, like, the ghost hunting, you know, how you have to constantly go to your goggles and use your PK meter and scan ghosts. And, like, I'm going
like
back through it a second
hunting,
time
right.
trying to capture
find
some of those
stuff,
ghosts that
right.
I missed and stuff. So there was some replay for me. But I was happy to say that the multiplayer automatically, you think, tacked on piece of crap. And actually, it worked really well. The way the multiplayer is it's four-player competitive co-op, so you are all fighting together, but at the same time you're competing with each other for
right.
points. So one mode is,
and you're doing the stages, or they're special stages.
They are. It was totally developed by a separate company, so they use the assets
wave?
From the game. Zipper or
oh,
not
okay.
Zipper? They're SOCOM.
Three Wave. Because I know Three Wave was involved, and they're the ones
that
make
those
the
are the
CTF.
Ones who make the multiplayer. Yes.
Okay. Okay.
Three
That's
Wave
awesome.
Made the multiplayer.
Okay.
And Terminal
that makes
Velocity
a lot of sense
made the
to me.
Single player.
Okay.
Okay.
We're gonna have to play, by the way, this weekend. All
right. So what they did is they took the assets from the game, but they're not the same. They're the same stages, but they're different.
Right.
They're modeled different.
Because there's a lot of single player stages that wouldn't. I
yes.
See
and there's
working.
Some in office buildings that aren't even in. There's some
okay.
stages that aren't
okay.
even in it.
That's cool.
But so what they do is there's kind of like. It's like Killzone, if you remember, where it cycles through different modes. So you have
right.
to play three or four different modes for it to constitute a game. And one of them is there's like treasures sitting in the middle of whatever stage you're on. And ghosts are constantly coming down trying to steal the treasures away. So you're zapping them away, trying to keep them away. One of the modes is you get extra time for how many – each time you slam dunk a zombie,
right.
it gets plus 15 and you try to last as long as you can. And then – my favorite mode is like the Nazi zombie mode. Wave one,
oh, yeah.
send some zombies. Wave two, and it only goes to 10 waves, but wave 10 always ends in a boss. So like the Stay Puft, you fight on rooftops through all these waves, and then wave 10, the Stay Puft comes up, and all of you have to fight him.
Nice.
And all that time, you can revive each other. And everyone has the proton stream, but it dropped the power-ups are the other weapons in the game.
Oh, see, that's what I was going to ask
so
you
So you can
too.
Get
okay.
the other weapons in the game, keep each other alive, and you want to keep each other alive because you'll die. I mean,
right.
you won't be able to score points if everything's coming after you. So it's a great way to try to do the most damage yet want to keep your players
that's
alive. It's just an interesting spin, and I was so happy that it just felt good. And not only that, but it's one of the few instances where all four of you are the main Ghostbusters running around.
And what did you – you had mentioned something to me about a money system. Is there
– Yeah, the way it works is based on like how long you last, you get money for it.
Oh, okay.
And then the money
okay.
earns you your new ranks, and then with the new ranks, you can get the add-ons to the weapons as opposed to just picking up the basic
okay.
weapon. Now yours
right.
has – the photon beam and stuff, so it gives you an excuse to level up
you.
Too.
Okay,
so it
there's
has
a
that
little
system
bit of like
behind
little
incentive
Call of Duty,
to replay
right.
it.
Yep,
okay. exactly.
So with that being said, and me saying I would rent it, do you think that this is a purchase?
I think this is a purchase. I think that the story alone, I think warrants multiple playthroughs, and I think the multiplayer is pretty sweet. Is it going to replace Call of Duty or any of those?
No.
Absolutely not. But it's fun when you get burned out on a session of Nazi zombies, and I was like, you know, I'm just going to try a round of Ghostbusters.
Just
really enjoy it. You know, it's one of those where you'll keep coming back and visiting it because it was a really neat experience. And I found games pretty smoothly. Like, it was pretty popular, so...
That's great.
That was good.
And again, Hutch, I'll you know, maybe we'll do like a follow up next week if you get a chance to play it. Again, you can fire through it really quickly. But
I'll briefly throw out too that, you know, me and my son played through the Wii version, and while it keeps the exact same story, which is really cool, they took
how gay was it on the Wii? Dude, were you like
no? But here's what they did. Actually, yeah. it was all right on the Wii, but they did the animated Ghostbusters cartoon. So they didn't try to do real life graphics. They
did
made
it have the gorilla
game. No, it did not have the gorilla.
Dude, the gorilla.
But it was really
cartoon.
Neat
man,
seeing.
Man, fuck that shit. The Wii can't even get that shit right.
It was neat seeing.
Was Slimer your sidekick?
It's not the frickin' cartoon. It just looks cartoony. It was modeled after them.
You said.
He did
I
say
said it was
cartoon.
Modeled after them. Modeled after the cartoon. They're models. All right. I didn't say the frickin' monkey. Slimer's not their sidekick.
They just left the gorilla out,
yes.
man.
But anyways.
Fucking haters. All right. Sorry.
All right.
No. What? Go.
I'm done. Let's go.
No.
He's pissed. You pissed him off. Dude.
I don't. Are you going to recommend the game to anyone?
No.
Did it at least have single player? Oh, wait. There is no multiplayer on the Wii. I forgot.
It had co-op. That was the whole reason I wanted to play it. I'm really into
but
co-op.
But don't buy it on the Wii, you say.
Not if you have a 360.
Yeah.
Yeah. All right. Well.
And if you have a PS3, you should still buy it on the 360.
Hutch is going to play through it. And yeah. And I liked it. I got, dude, pays mad homage to the
I am
going to so
I am going
to
play
it.
And then I'm going to play Blaze Blue some, dude.
Oh, hell yeah, dude. Hell yeah.
Epileptic Gaming's News of the Week.
All right, guys. Well, News of the Week is going to be a little bit different today because, well, there's just some, like, crazy things. Obviously, we're having a shortened show. By my calculation, what time do we start? About
11:15.
So we're doing pretty good right now. Yeah. And
we're going to do News of the Week, and then that's going to be it, huh?
Yeah, I mean, or we could just throw out a few news topics. We could open up the phone lines. Like, I really don't give a fuck. I mean, I would, you know, at least like to comment on Blast
Blue.
I'd
say we could open up the phone lines, but, you know, this is America's birthday, and we'll probably have some Euros calling and just ruin it.
That's okay.
Put a damper on our parade.
Man, you're a mad hater, dude.
I'm joking. I'm joking.
I did want to make at least a couple comments on Blast Blue, and I think we're going to be reviewing BlazBlue next week. We were playing a little bit before the show. Force, you mentioned almost immediately that the 2D animation,
dude,
is,
it looks
is awesome,
dynamite. In the
is.
Background, the way it's 2D yet 3D is just unbelievable too.
It's nice to know that genre still lives. You know, like I've always,
dude.
I mean, I love how they did Street Fighter 4. Don't get me wrong, because that is like the best 2D 3D hybrid I've seen. But there's something about a good old fashioned.
Dude, it's the best I've seen.
What, Guilty Gear?
No, this Blaze Blue. Oh my God, it's way better than anything Guilty Gear has done.
It's
but
it's
the Guilty
same,
Gear series always looked
group,
good
for the most part.
But yeah, when you look at the old school Darkstalkers, you know, Marvel versus Capcom 2D animated, this is so superior. It looks so like.
And you guys
kind of
got to see a little bit, but then
the camera failed.
Maybe we'll be able to get it set up so they can see a few games.
It's later. Like it's got all like Street Fighter. Type moves and whatnot, but it sort of has this like mischievous trickery combo system in that you do a lot of setups for what you're going to do. And I haven't played through all the characters yet, but I got to say, like, for a 2D fighter, I sat down last night and I felt like I could easily get into the game, but at the same time, there was still a lot of shit that I did not.
If you were a Street Fighter fan, you could jump into it pretty
easily. Totally,
totally.
Oh, yeah. It's very easy to pick up.
I didn't look at I've never played it before. I've seen it at a few conventions and whatnot. Haven't even picked up the instruction booklet yet. But I imagine that there is a lot more depth even to what I've seen, and I have enjoyed the shit out of it so far. However, you know, we'll take a look at it next week.
We will discover that depth together.
We'll find We'll find out. It's
hand in hand.
It's definitely interesting. And, you know, on the fighting game front, I also did pre-download Street Fighter 4 for PC.
Oh, you did. Yeah,
I'm looking for
Yeah, actually, when, no, we got it. We got an idea, actually. But
yeah.
Maybe. Maybe those in the Midwest
why
area.
Why do you say snore?
Would
why you have it for the 360 where all the players are?
Dude, hold on,
just,
hold on.
Why even
on.
Waste Let, one minute with the PC?
Okay, how
why,
about this?
Just keep
how
leveling
this?
Up your one dude
how about
on the 360.
This? How about this, dog? When your wife is like, "Yo, bitch, I want to watch fucking I don't know, insert gay medical show, gay, Grey's
I love New York
Anatomy here
goes to work,
and you want to play Street Fighter for like 6 hours." That no one can tell me to get the fuck off my computer, dog. I could sit down in my chair. I could pull out my stick.
You win. You win.
It's like, I mean, best $35 I ever fucking spent.
I didn't realize you were pussy whipped. You win.
What are you talking about?
You need it.
I still use the
pussy whipped version.
9 out of fucking.
So that's what I'm gonna forever say. I'm like, oh yeah, he's playing the pussy whipped version.
Dude, whatever.
The other thing is, dude, it's gonna be. Whatever. I think, you know, we're kicking around an idea of doing some tournaments around here, and
yeah.
Having it on the PC
is going to be the money.
Is going to be the
it's
money.
Going to be the money, dog.
It. What do you mean? You expect everyone to buy it for the PC?
No, dude. All
no,
you got to do
matter.
Is bring
it's
your
exactly
controller,
the same,
dude.
Yeah.
You,
oh,
all
just
your
bring your
USB 360 controller. Yeah.
Is it really such a hard concept to understand? Like,
yeah,
really?
I guess. I don't know.
I don't
to
know.
Play the pussy whipped version when you have the superior version at your home? Yes,
what are you
that is an extremely hard concept for me to wrap my head around.
You play on a PS or on a 360 pad anyway, so I don't want
to
hear it.
Dude, I've been trying my damnedest to not play on a 360 pad, so don't give me
any
shit.
See
I
what
finally
the problem
got a stick,
is.
Went and bought a fight pad.
I don't know why you guys have problems playing on the pad.
Dude, the 360
because
pad is
the
worst pad ever
sucks.
Invented. And I love my 360, but it's not the worst motherfucker ever.
Why do I not have issues playing on the pad?
Dude.
Why?
You have issues.
No, I don't.
I see you throw out that fucking taunt every once in a while.
Yeah, I do throw out the taunt. But you know what, dude? You know what you do on your stick? You fucking pull up your fucking Xbox menu.
Yeah, but that was my fault.
So, because he's learning it.
Hold on, fuckface. There's a lock on there. I just
I'd rather taunt in the
asshole.
In the force in the flow of gameplay than be like, oh shit, sorry, dude. I pulled up the menu.
I forgot to turn the frickin' lock switch on.
I'm pretty sure that Ed's had a menu hitting moment too, I don't know if we should be talking.
I'm sure.
When I was using the freaking stick.
Haters, haters, stay home. All right, I guess, where to start? I want to start first off with probably kind of a correlation. Me saying, is the concept so hard to understand the thought of Street Fighter on PC when it unifies the controller setting? Well, here's another concept that seems so easy to understand, you guys, but Ben Blizzard kind of fucking throws a wrench into your plans. So it's been announced that there will not be any LAN support.
There's a
Starcraft
petition
2.
On Facebook. Have you signed it?
Oh, if it's on Facebook, dude it's probably going to happen.
No.
I think internet petitions
no,
are about
I'm just
as
throwing
fucking...
this out there. This kid comes into the bar the other day and goes,
oh, no.
Hutch, did you hear that there's no LAN capability
Starcraft
2? And I was like, yeah. He's like, dude. Sign my petition on Facebook.
Oh my god!
Well, I was like,
Hutch, sign my petition. Not only they're not going to include LAN support, but the Zerglings have
sign
exactly
my petition.
3 hit points less than they had in the pre-patch before Brood War, and on Battle.net you could really just exploit the hell out of that. Sign my petition. It's going to do a lot.
What don't I understand? What someone's saying? I don't understand.
What?
I understand.
No, they were talking about the Street Fighter 4 PC.
I understand Street Fighter 4 on the
Ed
PC.
I don't know why.
Dude,
Force
people just want to hate me so much that fucking it's like, oh, Ed's on the air. Hey, let me go take a shit and shove it in my ears so I fucking can misunderstand everything.
Dude,
he
and guys,
says.
The reason why I hate on the freaking PC
God,
is because
dude.
You play it on a freaking little 22-inch GIMP monitor. When I play my shit on my giant
plasma
you
know what,
surround
Force,
screen in
I
my
totally,
living room with superior competition.
I play. What do you mean? Dude.
You'll never win that argument. As long as the 360 dominates, that's where everyone will be.
We'll see.
No, I'm going to play it on my 360. Of course, I'm not like giving it up. I'm just saying I have this bomb-ass alternate now.
Dude,
no.
Have you seen my monitor?
When your wife drops her balls and says, get out.
Dude, I have a nice 20-inch LG monitor, dude. This shit's dope.
Yeah. And I have a really nice 22-inch widescreen monitor that I freaking... has shitty two PC speakers. I don't. Gotta put
it's
headphones
not even
on.
About the two. It's about having the freedom.
The sad thing
God,
is the only
July
thing,
4th,
the sad thing
you just
is
can't
the only thing
the
I watch on
hater.
That. The only thing I see on that sweet ass screen of mine is fucking Warhammer and porn.
Dude, playing on my PC really almost feels like playing on my PSP. Because like God. I go, I'm like in front of my big TV all day long, like, and then I go to my PC.
Super drastic.
Yeah, you know? And my TV does have an HDMI port on it, so
let's
I can just plug my video card right into my TV or plug my computer.
Did you read why it was? Do you agree with why they made it?
Because they want people to use BattleNet.
Well, they said, yeah, piracy.
Well, I...
Do you not agree that people pirated the shit out of StarCraft?
Yes, they did. However, that, you know, I mean, connect to BattleNet. That's fine. But then underneath BattleNet, have a LAN option.
Well, do you... That's what I was going to say. Do you go anywhere without internet nowadays?
But, dude...
I mean, you'll still be able to LAN each other. You'll still be able to set
okay,
up a private
enough,
game.
Fair enough. Like, you and I, when if we play, it probably wouldn't be that big of a deal. But let's imagine that, oh, there's $50,000 on the line. Here we are at some convention center where there, you know, two guys are playing.
BattleNet crashes
and
right, some shit.
And
I know,
like,
yeah,
you know,
man,
then that. Suddenly you're just like, wait a second. This company has, like, done... And they've done so much to, like, advance esports and
right,
advance
yeah.
competitive gaming, both in Korea and worldwide. And it just seems like such a ludicrous deal, even outside of the piracy thing. Like, there has to be something
else. Well, I was
going to
say, I was playing Zombies last night, and no games would start. It would say server connection timed out for, like, a half hour. So I can totally now understand
maybe,
how that shit happens at the wrong time.
Maybe
it's bad.
They're going to... revolutionize the way that shit's gonna
See,
work.
Like,
maybe they've got something
but no,
secret in the
how
works.
Is it gonna revolutionize? I mean, like, you and I were, you know, we're in a secluded cabin on a vacation. We got our laptops up there. We're like, fuck, let's play
we're
some
naked.
StarCraft too. We're like naked. We got beer cans all around us.
Hell yeah. It's a guy's
PBR,
weekend.
and we can't play. Like, that's there's something not right about that, you guys. There's something.
Why are they doing it, though?
I don't
I mean,
piracy is what they said. Keeps them from pirating. You have to be online to play it.
I mean, I understand.
So here's
that's the future.
Here's
that's
my
the,
only.
We're just gonna
now,
have to deal with that
I mean,
from now on
well,
on the PC.
Here's my only like my only thought about this. Okay, guys. And I have put a lot of thought into this because I think about it from the competitive. You know, all these competitions and tournaments. The way that they do Arena for World of Warcraft is a similar thing, right? You can't really LAN Arena, but what you do is you connect to Arena servers and, you know, you play against other guys
right.
and other clans. So what they typically do at these competitions is Blizzard actually brings out a machine that activates as a realm server. And this realm server is identical to what people connect to on the internet. So
do you think Blizzard was thinking about this ahead of time? You're not going to have those problems with those tournaments because we'll only be the ones throwing
listen,
them.
Listen. I think Blizzard was thinking ahead of time
yeah.
because now they can go, yes, to have a local BattleNet server so that you can have LAN-based StarCraft competitions.
You got
to
pay us
You
got to
pay
money.
Us $25,000. And you know what? All the Koreans are going to
pay
it. All the worldwide competitions, they're going to pay it.
They will.
So ultimately, I do think, and I mean, throwing it out there. From,
so it's like a win-win. Not only will they not pirate, but now you got to come to us for
right.
every.
So my gamer thoughts are, yo, dude, that's fucked up. Why would they do that?
But
from
business.
A business
yeah,
perspective,
exactly.
it's like. That's the right thing to do. You know, these companies are always looking for ways to capitalize.
And now,
Blizzard's hurting
and now, dude.
Blizzard's
and
hurting
now.
For money, so I'm glad that they figured
yeah.
out a way to support
yeah,
their family.
Yeah, clearly Blizzard's hurting for money, and that takes it back to the gamer perspective. It's like, fuck you, you assholes,
no,
dude.
But you know,
why
I mean,
the fuck are you going to tax me to play a game that I'm already paying you to play, dude?
But they...
I just want to say, read our little chat. I agree with what you guys are saying right now.
What?
This is all going to be a moot point, because when it comes out, they'll find some way to hack that shit, make private servers. Everyone will be doing what they wanted to do anyway.
Yeah.
It'll just take like two extra days before they're doing it.
And you know what? I'm sure someone's going to be able to have like emulate a BattleNet server, but I think that's why they've rewritten it. I think that's why it's kind of like going to be. And I have no doubt BattleNet 3.0 is probably going to be, or what is it, 2.0? I don't even know what the new BattleNet is going to be fucking awesome. But I would totally expect that the local BattleNet servers. That's going to be the way they're going to go.
I totally agree with you the second you said it.
Skrilla, motherfuckers. Yeah. So also in other StarCraft news is that the beta is planned to last like 4 to 6 months. So that still probably puts us into like a 2010 release date, which is
so with your Blizzard connects, you're going to be seeing a beta
for sure.
Hell yeah,
dude! Not where that.
Look, there wasn't even any hesitation in his voice. He's looking at you like, dude. What fuck? What are you asking
smoking?
Me that question?
And also, I do have three BlizzCon mount cards for World of Warcraft. So if there's any avid World of Warcraft players that want to buy them off of me, they also include StarCraft 2 keys. So,
oh, dude,
DJ Weed at djweed.tv.
Contact us. Wow. He's going to tax you.
I got three. I'll throw in a dude. Goodie bag.
Hey, James. James. Come here real quick.
Uh-oh. What's Mini Week coming in here for?
You see this little dude right here? You guys got to help pay for his college. He's a grown guy. So don't think that shit's coming cheap. All right. Say bye, James.
Hey, go say bye.
Go, James, say,
go
bye.
Say bye. All right. All right. That was Mini Wheat.
Perfect.
All right. No, you cannot buy him. That would not be okay.
He's only selling like one of his kidneys and you can buy it.
Right. So I was actually surprised to learn about this force, but Red Faction Guerrilla, downloadable content
coming.
Dude, awesome. It actually.
You know what they did, though? That makes me a little hesitant as they talked about extending the single player story. I want some mention of. You know, more Wrecking Crew maps, you know, more.
No,
more
they said there is definitely Wrecking Crew maps. I read the Kotaku article and then I went on Games Press and actually read the press release. And they talk about a whole new campaign, new like bad guys and new stuff. And then they said, you know, two maps that were going to be for multiplayer and the other, they classified it as the other game modes in Red Faction Guerrilla.
Awesome.
So I've only got to assume that that's got to be Wrecking
And you
want to
know what they said that really makes me happy? Because Saints Row did it, the game I love. But their downloadable content, Grand Theft Auto, they use the same areas and just give you new story. These, they promised new zones, not reusing old zones, actual new zones.
Which is cool because that's bet you it's just going to become an extension of the map.
Giving me a whole new zone and all the little things that come with it, that's cool.
That's awesome. So I loved Red Faction Guerrilla. If you guys listened to our battle in the sandbox,
Have you seen that? I mean, we called it, dude. That battle's all over the place. The Prototype versus Infamous versus...
Yeah,
nice. I've been seeing a lot
it
of magazines
is.
Are totally divided. I see nines for Guerrilla, and then I see sevens. I'm like, wow.
Everyone has just been like something different. So, well, Ed, you know, here's the reason why we wanted to get the fuck out of Dodge when we decided to bring our giant ships over to what is now the United States of America, away from, you know,
oppression.
And
potato
that is
famine.
That is because Guitar Hero will be released here in the United States for a very fair $120.
DJ.
Did I say Guitar. DJ Hero? I meant
no,
DJ.
You meant DJ Hero.
I meant DJ Hero.
DJ
Hero.
How much
will be
did
released
you just
here
say?
For $120.
Okay, all right, $120.
That's pretty decent because
right.
you're getting what?
Pretty
the,
decent.
You're getting the...
Yeah, you're getting the turntable, you're getting some shit.
And that's kind of one of those,
and
like,
who's
you
doing,
just got to do
it,
the initial purchase.
Who's doing the turntable? Is it?
No, it's just developed in-house. Okay. But it looks...
Oh, it's not Red Octane making it?
No, I mean, yeah, but okay. it's like, it's not like Newmark or Techniques or
Technique is making one, I believe.
No, Newmark made one for DJ Scratch.
Oh, they did.
Yeah. Anyway... Over there in the oppressed Britain, they will be paying $170 for that shit. Oh!
Wow.
In the ass.
Wow, that's where your ass is?
I don't know. I don't know. Don't ask any further questions about that. All I got to say is,
dude the collapse will be bad.
No,
remember that
up.
Story?
Yes. I forgot about it for years until you just brought it up that moment.
The collapse will be bad.
Holy
I
want to
look at my lover in his eyes.
$180, they're saying. So $179, damn. Whatever. Point being is that...
That's a huge mark. That's what, one third of the price.
I wonder why they're doing that. That doesn't make any... Oh, I guess it does make sense from a business perspective.
I don't know, dude.
Because techno is so big in Europe, I imagine.
Dude, I don't
those
know.
Those fuckers will buy it. They'll buy it.
I didn't see any sort of other explanation other than like, oh, tough shit, guys. Tough shit.
That's a good thought, though. They'll pay it. That's where it's. That's probably where it's the largest. That's
it is where it's the largest, dude, and they will pay it.
So there was this funny article, and I didn't even, like, read it. I just read the headline, and then I had an instant response to it. And the headline was, so why didn't we Ghostbusters copy the cartoon? And it's kind of funny because you mentioned it. And I was thinking to myself, because it sucked! And at least they did go for, like, a movie approach.
The real Ghostbusters cartoon sucked?
Come on, dude.
Dude, the thoughts I have of it are fond. Sure, if
gorilla.
I go back and rewatch it, it'll suck. But
the gorilla.
At the time.
I don't know about that, guys.
Come on.
What I was going to say that you guys interrupted me on is it was crazy seeing, you know, you play the 360 version and then see the exact same story told through the Wii graphics.
Oh, it
graphics.
Was?
It's the exact same story, the exact same actors, the exact same scenes.
Holy
Their models
shit.
Are just different. And it was weird. It was creepy.
No, I didn't say the Wii sucked, Combat Cal. If you listen, I said the real Ghostbusters, the Ghostbusters cartoon sucked.
Combat Cal.
Man, learn to read.
I'm saying the Wii sucks. Yeah. Dude. That shit's fucking a gimmick.
I say the Wii has its moments.
Obviously, Combat Cal needs some sort of Wii peripheral that helps him with reading.
I'll tell you what. After Super Nintendo, and I don't care what anybody says, oh, the Nintendo 64 owned. Yeah, three games owned.
I'm thinking
the
like
fucking
five.
GameCube owned. Yeah.
I had like five.
Owned. But since the Super Nintendo, dude, I really think Nintendo needs to just dip the fuck out of the console market, dude. Concentrate on handhelds and like making their games for a different unit.
There's also another actual group, or maybe I could say blogger in specific, that wants a console to dip out of the market, Ed. An MSNBC blogger. So apparently that's someone who writes for MSNBC, but then they also have like their own little like opinion articles. MSNBC, the MS standing for Microsoft, wrote a nice article that was basically like titled "The PS3 Won't Last Another Year."
Oh yeah, you told me about this one. What was the reasoning behind it?
The reasoning was the, you know, the games, the fact that they haven't had the price drop, the fact that, you know, that their install base is not as big as it should be right now. You know, I mean, it was the same sort of regurgitation that we've seen and heard over time. They didn't mention anything about like the motion or anything like that, but they did mention that like Natal was coming out, so it didn't, I mean, it was obviously like
skewed a little bit.
This is the problem. People don't need to bank on Natal being the PS3 killer. It's not going to do that.
Do you think that this article came out because, I mean, we said this week too, we read the article that said by 2015 PS3 will be the dominant
machine
in the household.
Right. So that's the flip side. Tell me about this article because you were the one that brought it to my attention.
Well, I don't even know who the hell Wedbush Morgan is.
So they're like an analyst company, right? So these are guys
so they just
that
make
like
predictions.
They collect data and then based off of trends, yes, they make like forecasts per se.
Well, according to their forecast,
are
they say
what the fuck are they, Nostradamus?
That's exactly. But that's all they do is they just like predict shit. I honestly want someone who's done an in-depth look at like
they,
how often.
Well, I mean,
right.
Dude. What they probably have is like 100-plus page document that explains it all. And then, you know, you got the summary. But essentially, they're taking like the data of the growth of the PS3, the growth of the 360, the growth
of
the PS2.
Well, they're also looking at like what they think that Slim is going to do, too.
So right, exactly.
They're saying by 2013.
15
is what they're saying.
In 5 years, Sony will once again be the dominant force on the market.
Well, you know what? I've read predictions, too. And it's a good thing for us that the world's coming to an end in 2012.
That's why it is.
Is that Emmerich's new date?
You know what? In the grand scheme of things, I would probably say that the PS3 would survive an apocalyptic event over the 360. I mean,
I think that's how it's going to be.
If I had to be stuck on an island with the machine I thought would last the longest, it would probably be my PS3.
Yeah. So
well, plus you have
physically. I mean, if I was bringing the one I had the most enjoyment out of, I'd bring the 360 if I was going for enjoyment. But that's almost like it's just weird the timing on that article. Well, who cares about 2015? They won't even be here until 2010.
Yeah.
You
know?
Yeah. We got to quickly bust out this press release saying, no, they only got a year.
Yeah, and didn't these guys also say something about their motion control, which I found really surprising?
Yeah, what they talked about was that they think that the PS3 motion controller will be way superior and catch on with gamers because there is no way that you can use the Natal to play any kind of hardcore game, which I agree with. I'm not
they
doubting.
They must listen to EG, dude.
I never doubted that.
Regular viewers
I never
of
doubted
the
no, and I never
I,
doubted
I,
that.
I agree
the Natal will be for a different type of game.
The Natal will be for
But they said that they've seen the wand. They know what the wand can do. They can actually see hardcore applications for it because
the
it's the most exact
we saw on
of the
Jimmy
devices.
Kimmel Live or whatever, dude. That's,
still
that's
fun.
What the Natal
still
is.
Fun.
But for me, Natal is the whole fucking vocal recognition.
Waving my menus.
Waving my menus.
Trying on my dresses.
It's just like me.
Shit. Okay.
That's awesome.
So the other thing is that in like probably the worst case of games industry leakage, right? PSP Go gets ruined for PlayStation. Ico 3 got, you know, ruined. All those, you know, Last Guardian, all those things that got basically leaked or ruined by, you know, they lost their hype. So a while ago, that PS3 Slim pictures came out, and everyone was screaming, bullshit, 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 bullshit. Other people were like, it's actually, we think it's pretty real. I was on the real side, but now it has been confirmed that these things are being manufactured. And what's
Wait a minute. They are being made right now, or they finally signed a contract to get them made?
I'm sorry. Yes, they are in the... They're, like, probably setting up assembly lines. And they've signed contracts. Thank you. They're not, like... Rolling off the assembly line.
Well, I was wondering,
Bob,
does that mean that box
PS3
was
Slim.
Real?
Yes. I think it, or at least like a prototype.
That was a prototype
this
box.
Is what our box is going to look like for a manufacturing prototype, which is obviously, that's what they're going to make, you know, shit up. Mini-Wheat, I know you're excited about the PS3 Slim, but just tone it down a couple more minutes.
What is wrong with your cat?
What is he doing?
Dude, have you ever seen The Exorcist when the head starts spinning crazy?
Epileptic gamers have an epileptic
was
cat,
he, was
dude.
Was he swinging around? Sashi, come here.
His head, he was like, rah, 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 dude.
Sashi, he's probably dizzy.
He was eating something.
Now you're like freaking me out about the,
okay,
about the cat.
Okay, yeah, I think it's
fine.
Sashi's fine.
James, out, Mini-Wheat. The other weird thing about this article is that they are saying that it's going to be ready by the end of July.
Wow.
Which doesn't make sense if they're going to have a price drop at Tokyo Game Show or they
when
gonna
is
announce
Tokyo
something.
Game Show?
I don't think it's till September.
Yeah,
dude.
That's what I was thinking. If anything would happen, it would happen there. Because they like to break their news to the Japanese before they do us. I think that date is bullshit. Like, there was really never any doubt in my mind that a PS3 would come eventually. That's what Sony does.
There you go.
I mean, that's a no-brainer.
There it is right here. Ready by July.
I can't see them just bringing that out without some huge marketing behind it.
It's, you know, it's just a little surprising. I was expecting it to happen, but I was thinking
I would
maybe
thinking
late
magazines
holiday.
And print and stuff would be showing ads right. for right now if that was coming. That seems silly.
Right.
But Sony does silly shit, so I'm not putting it past
yeah,
them.
Yeah, it's got to be cheaper. I would hope that it has got to be cheaper. But they said that it was just kind of light and more efficient, so we'll see. Or they'll bring it out
and
at the price,
drop the price
and
of
drop
the
original,
ones.
Which is probably a pretty good idea too. And then hopefully, you know,
when the PS3
no matter what Sony says, no matter what any articles say, guys, it's just common knowledge that a machine will go down in price.
Yeah,
stop
dude,
freaking
look.
Talking about it. It's just no shit.
Inevitable.
Machines go down in price yeah. on their own.
It
show.
Won't go down. It's gonna stay like that.
Yeah,
oh,
even,
I'm so tired of those people.
Even
and
that
then
doesn't make
the
sense.
Market dictates when your machine isn't
to.
Selling. And you have all this product sitting there collecting dust and not making you money. You need to do
something.
Well,
when's the last time you saw a machine come out for $200
and
next week it was $250?
Yeah.
yeah. That happens all the time.
It's laissez-faire. I mean, it's... Jesus, dude. People don't...
Not including eBay.
It will happen eventually. All right, so unless there's any other news items, that's just kind of like the summary of I had. This
well,
week
I did
was
no,
kinda,
you know what I did want to talk about
that, that
made me wonder if you guys would change your mind at all was in that article about PS3 dominating. They said that the Wii HD will be coming out. Like, would that, if it had HD 720p graphics, would that change your mind about it at all?
So I could see fucking Slimer as your buddy nicer.
Or is it you just you hate the control so much that no matter how good it looks.
So wait, hold on. They would just so they
now,
would
I don't
just,
know how it would
what,
work.
Yeah, what
but mean, let's just say it had 720p graphics, looked super
you know
bomb
what?
On your
here's,
HD.
Here's
would that
what
make
I
you
would
a little
say.
More open to it?
I think here's what I would say is that I would only be open to it after trying out Sony's motion controllers because if like one, you know, if the same coolness is going to end up on the PS3, then there's no reason for me to have other than first party games.
I was going to say, other, I mean, what about the Nintendo games themselves?
You know, they're always going to yeah. be able to like, I mean, I'm pissed. Let's, and I'm pissed that I can't play Tatsunoko versus Capcom. You know, like shit like that is going to piss me off to the point where I feel like one day I will buy a Wii again.
I hope that day comes when you play Galaxies, dude.
You won't. You will not buy a Wii again. You will not. You won't.
What?
I guarantee you won't. You will not buy a Wii again.
If I could get a good deal on a used one just to play Tatsunoko versus Capcom, if they don't bring it out, probably. Well, but then I don't have a stick either. See, that's fucking gay.
Yeah,
dude.
See,
what a stupid ass decision on their part.
Like I got the pad.
That pad still isn't enough.
But
dude
they're
that pad's awesome.
They're
the Wii
revolutionizing
pad is
gaming,
sweet.
Don't you know?
I would be very
it's Nintendo,
skeptical for
dude.
I would be very skeptical.
I'm just wondering if that was like the
I mean,
major
are you
barrier.
Talking like are you
like,
talking
I'm just
about literally a 360 capable
what
like,
I, what I really
machine?
Wanted to know was the biggest barrier to the Wii, the graphics or the controller? That was really my question.
The biggest barrier to the Wii is the Wii.
The biggest barrier
No, honestly.
To the, yeah,
you I, have to choose one of
no,
the
no,
other.
No, no,
what
no.
What do you
no.
hate the most about it? The graphics compared to what we're getting nowadays or the fact that you wand and stick it?
I hate everything about it, dude. I hate the
graphics. One or the other. Shh. One or the other. Which do you hate more?
Dude, why you gotta put me on the spot like this?
Because I'm just wondering, because I don't think it actually controls that bad in the games that use it properly. But I always agree that the graphics always
dude,
look like
do you
shit.
Like do you like the fact that you can't really play any of your games multiplayer online?
Yeah, see that was the see I was gonna say it's more like that trifecta. Huh? It's not like any one overpowers
the
other
thing
because
is that I don't I'm not really into any multiplayer Wii titles.
I know, but still like any lack of like just signing
see,
in.
If I wanted to buy Call of Duty
5
for
or,
the Wii, you that has full multiplayer. Games have it nowadays. Nintendo games, a lot of Nintendo games still do friend code, but they've are games are getting past that. Now.
I can't. I'm flustered, dude. I really don't know.
I was just wondering because I don't mind the controls when they're
see,
handled correctly.
By the time
that's the thing,
by,
it's
by the
also
time,
shitty, you just don't want it at all.
That's kind. But by the time
I don't
force
agree with that.
That an HD Nintendo box comes out, I think that Natal and Sony's motion will probably like.
They'll both be out there, but I mean, just remember, they won't ever have Nintendo behind them.
I know, which is fucking lame, but at the same time, like, Nintendo better start stepping up the quality of their first-party titles and not fucking including shit like, here, let's put down the controller and watch it play for itself, you know? Like, I mean,
that's,
there's a
that,
reason.
That direction their heading's really upsetting
my
stomach.
You know what?
Yeah. What, dog?
You should play our American, proud to be American.
What?
Since oh, we can end the show with that for
the
in honor of the
fourth. And then end with game over.
I do. You know what? I could probably do that.
I think we should.
I could probably do that. So next week, as we mentioned, DEERA will be taking Force's spot. Force will be out. Sorry, yeah, boo.
Sorry,
Force.
Guys. It's not by choice. It is not
week.
By choice. And actually, when I come back, guys, I'll be telling you about Call of Juarez 2.
Dude,
I finally got my hand on it. You guys
is.
Know how much I love Part 1. I was like the only guy in the world who liked Part 1. So we'll see what I think about that.
Yeah,
one when I come
back. I'm going to be really curious because I played that a little bit and it wasn't.
Yeah, we played a PC one that was like pre-alpha
right.
piece of shit. It was a different game when it finally hit the 360.
Okay. All right. Well, I. Oh, look there. I do have it. Sweet.
Right there.
Fantastical.
Fantastical.
It's
they sound like one of those robots from Transformers. That's something.
Oh my
say.
God, dude!
That was fantastical.
So, I do want to mention for anyone wondering, this week Live on 3 is going to be on Sunday. Colin Burrell is going to be moving to Monday, so I won't have to do two freaking shows a day.
I knew that was gonna be tough.
Well, now Suma doesn't have exactly work obligations, so we're gonna.
He got fired again.
He's unemployed.
He's unemployed.
Is that
he
what?
Did.
Is that the nice way to say fine. He's unemployed?
Yes.
And actually,
yes.
I was just kidding. So I'm actually sorry to hear that, Suma.
Yeah, it
that
really
does suck,
it kind of sucks.
It does
but,
suck. To
it
lose
does
a job.
Happen. It does happen. He'll bounce back.
You know what,
back.
Suma? If you know, you don't. You don't do well out there in California. You can always.
I told him that, dude. Suma, step one is sleep with the boss, dude. How'd you screw that up?
I thought that was your MO.
His
boss was a woman.
Suma, you seen how beautiful
not
my
a man.
Girl,
oh,
you see how beautiful bummer. My girlfriend is, dude. There's plenty of dudes as pretty as she is out here that would love you.
Yeah, at least plenty of dudes. I would say there's a lot of dudes, but that's just me. So, all right, guys. Well, I want to say happy 4th of July, Independence Day, whatever. Blow shit up day to all you folks out there. And we will end with a nice little message that came out. This, I don't know how many people actually got a chance to see this, but it's all about the American way.
It's
right.
America.
It's all about the
and
American
finally,
way.
Finally, like a message for the people that Force agrees with.
Yes, so we're not going to take open phones this week. Sorry, guys. But next week when we return, we'll have DEERA, Nice Guy Ed, myself. We'll be taking your open phones, talking about BlazBlue, and I really look forward to that show. Yeah. Be safe this 4th of July, motherfuckers. Seriously, I don't want to be hearing about anyone doing some stupid shit.
Yeah, or if you do stupid shit, don't let us know.
Don't worry.
Exactly.
I will do all the stupid shit
for you.
You.
Yes, let Ed do it. He's impervious. Remember, he was raised by a gypsy, so there's some sort of strange like anti-curses on him and whatnot. So, all right, guys, any final words before we get going?
Nope.
Have fun tomorrow, guys.
Yeah,
that's what it's
blast,
all about.
Man. These next 3 days, fucking live it up and celebrate our independence, man. That's
yes.
America... Love
America.
It or hate it. It's a beautiful
fuck
country.
Yeah.
And, you know, we've given a lot to the world.
And I'm just like, I got to get through the motions
including,
of the day so I can get back to gaming.
Including Epileptic Gaming.
Yes, guys. And this is your Epileptic Gaming public service announcement for July 4th, 2009. We'll see you next week here on Epileptic Gaming.
If tomorrow all the things were gone, I'd work for all my life, and I had to start again with just my children and my wife. I thank my lucky stars to be living here today, 'cause the flag still stands for freedom, and they can't take that away. I'm proud to be an American, where at least I know I'm free. And I won't forget the men who died, who gave that right to me. And I gladly stand up next to you and defend her still today, 'cause there ain't no doubt I love this land. God bless the U.S.
Hello, friends. Regardless of your political affiliation, Democrat, Republican, Independent, we as Americans agree our country is suffering economic hardship. Our current president and our past president both recognize the need for the American consumer to do their part in revitalizing our floundering economy. Now, as a gamer, you may be sitting there telling yourself, hey, I do my part. I buy games. Fact. Many American gamers have spent anywhere from $100 to $200 more on a foreign-made video game console system. Fact, several of these gamers merely months later found themselves unemployed, destitute, and standing in a bread line. The truth of the matter, citizens, is that this extra money could have been better spent and put back into our economy. Countrymen. It's time that we stood up and took responsibility. It is our duty, no, it is our moral obligation to give back to this great nation. So, the next time you're considering which video game console system to buy, remember, be a patriot. Give back to this country. Bye, American.
I'm proud to be an American. There ain't no doubt I love this land. God bless.
That's right, bitches. Bye, American. We will see you next week here on Epileptic Gaming. Force got the fuck out of here, but Nice Guy Ed and DJ Wheat say be safe. We'll see you next week. Peace.